We want to welcome each and every one of you to this time of praise and worship. As we worship as a family, we want to invite you also to join with us. Why do we need to praise and worship? Because we are worshiping the Creator, the one who created you and I, the one who created everything that we look around us. He deserves all the honor and glory. Not only that, He is so powerful, He is very personal too. He died for you and I on the cross. He gave Himself up. Everything that He had, He gave Himself up for you and I. So He deserves all of our honor, our worship, our praise. He has been so good to you and I. So let's thank Him. Let's worship Him. When we do that, everything that is bothering us, that is pulling us down, all the anxiety, all the fear, they'll all run away. When you look at the goodness and the greatness of our Lord, He's our Father. He can do anything for you and I. And He always does good because He is a good, good Father. So can we sing the song, "Even So Come"? This Father, He said, "I need to go to heaven because I'm going to prepare a mansion for you and I, where I can come back and take you to be with me." We are the bride and He is the bridegroom, preparing a mansion and coming to take us back with Him. So let's sing this song, "Even So Come." Like a bride waiting for her groom, we the church are waiting for you, O Lord Jesus. Let's sing this song.
Jesus, come. Even so, come, Lord Jesus, come.
Yes, Lord, that's our heart's cry. Saying, even so, come. Lord Jesus, please come. We are ready and waiting for you. When you look at all the things that are happening all around us, we know that these are the last days. We don't have to be afraid of these last days because we know our Lord Jesus coming is very near. As a bride waiting for the groom, let's be with an expectant heart, saying, Maranatha, come soon, Lord. We are ready. Amen. We're going to sing the song Forever. This song talks about how our Lord Jesus, He died on the cross for us. The song says, the moon and stars, they wept. The morning sun was dead. The Savior of the world was fallen, His body on the cross. We all need to understand what our sins, our misgivings, our shortcomings, what they have done. It made the Creator of this universe to die such a gruesome death. But that's not it. He is a Savior because He gave Himself on the cross. But on the third day, the song goes on to say, the ground began to shake. Amen? That's what happened. And the tomb was open. Even today we can go to Israel and see an open tomb of our Lord Jesus Christ. So let's sing this song, realizing what our Savior did on the cross, and above all, the victory that He gained for us. So much so, we can sing hallelujah. Let's sing this. The moon and stars, they wept. The morning sun was dead. The Savior of the world was fallen. His body on the cross, His blood poured out for us. The weight of every curse upon Him. One final breath He gave, as heaven looked away, the Son of God was laid in darkness. A battle in the grave, the war on death was waged, the power of hell forever broken.
The ground began to shake. The stone was rolled away. His perfect love could not be overcome. Now death, where is your sting? Our resurrected King has rendered you defeated. Forever He is glorified. He's risen, He is alive, He is alive.
The ground began to shake,
the stone was rolled away, His perfect love could not be overcome. Now death, where is your sting? The King has rendered you defeated. Forever He is glorified. Forever He is lifted high. Forever He is risen. He is alive. He is alive.
you, Lord, for your sacrifice. Are we ready to sing hallelujah?
Hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, the Lamb is overcome. We sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, the Lamb is overcome. We sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, the Lamb is overcome. We sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, we sing hallelujah, the Lamb is overcome.
Amen. Forever he is glorified, forever he is lifted high, forever he is risen and is no longer in his grave. As he said in the beginning, there is still an open tomb, an empty tomb to go to Jerusalem, because the Lord is risen. Amen. Amen. That gives us hope that whatever might be the situation you might be going through today, there is an end, there's a light at the end of the tunnel. Amen. So let's continue to rejoice. Our Lord Jesus. Amen. We're going to sing the song 10,000 Reasons. What are those 10,000 reasons? Those are the 10,000 and more reasons that we can thank God, right? It's amazing how much God has done for each and every one of us. But unfortunately, what comes at the top of our mind is what we don't have, the trouble that we might be going through today, or tomorrow. Let's train our hearts, let's train our minds to thank God, to take time, to worship Him. I said, let's come into His presence to praise and worship Him. One of the ways that we could worship Him is to thank Him for all that He has done to us. Amen. The sun comes up, the sun goes up, comes down and goes up on its own. The heart keeps beating on its own. We have no control absolutely. But God makes all of this happen so systematically in our lives. So let's thank God and worship Him as we sing this song, 10,000 Reasons.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before. Your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to see.
sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. You're rich in love and Your glory. My strength is failing, the end draws near, and my time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then Amen. Let's continue to worship Him. Let's continue to thank Him for all He is and all He has done in our lives. Let's not leave even one day to go by without thanking Him, because He deserves all the honor and glory. He deserves all of our praises. And when we do that, all the walls that are in front of us, they break down. That's how the walls of Jericho came down, because they went ahead praising and worshiping the Lord. Let's continue to do that, and every wall in our lives will break down. May God richly bless you. Thank you so much for participating in this praise and worship. And we pray and we know that God is in your life, God is in our lives, breaking the barriers. A God who is forever and ever, who is lifted high, He is still there with us. So let's continue to thank Him. Let's continue to worship Him, because He deserves all the glory. Above all, let's be with an expectant heart, asking, Lord, when are you going to come back? I want to be with you. Let's not get too comfortable with the life out here. Let's be ready to be caught up in the air any moment. Can we do that? Thank you. Thank you. May God richly bless you.